Welcome back to Adobe Think Tank, and make sure to use hashtag AdobeTT if you're tweeting along. With me is Virginia Backaitis, reporter CMSWire and a Digital Polaris. Virginia, thanks for joining us.
Oh, thank you for having me.
First question I want to get with you is, why is it so difficult, and I mean this is kind of a loaded question, but why is it so difficult to recruit and retain top tech talent?
Well, one is the unemployment rate is basically extremely low.
Yeah.
So almost everybody who wants 4%. To have a job yeah. already has one.
Sure.
And so basically the only thing you can do with tech talent is play musical chairs.
Right.
So if you pull somebody out of one job, you have to put them into another one. And they can pretty much name their project and name their price.
And when we're getting into like higher tech fields, where it's a limited amount of people, right, that can actually do that position, I mean, that becomes even more difficult. Are you seeing kind of initiatives being done to try and, you know, persuade people to get into these specific fields, especially AI?
Well, I mean, obviously colleges have programs now, and people are graduating at crazy rates, but nobody wants to hire people that are recent college graduates, so it will take time.
Sure.
Before
it's a 4, 5, 6 year cycle.
Yeah, before the field begins to populate. And then the other thing is that the data scientists and the AI people who are already out there have decided that this is what I want to specialize. And so they might be in biotech. And so then for them to come over and work for a marketing company or something like that is not what they want to do. So the field of people who are interested in a particular area in data science or machine learning or AI, you know, they only want to do, let's say, biology, looking at molecular slides or
sure.
something like that, and they don't want to go help marketers, you know, create great campaigns. And
the other way around too.
I think that a lot of people
yes.
who are used to producing really great ads and really great content really don't want to go figure out what kind of disease, you know, a particular they're seeing under
it's
a microscope slide.
Yeah, they're kind of two polarized fields. So, you know, when it comes to like enterprise content management, where can machine learning kind of help with that, or can it?
Well, you know, I guess the same way as with images and things like that, it can tag things, it can help people search for things.
Sure.
You know, let's say if you're making a lot of enterprise content management, some of it is about getting drug submissions through the FDA.
Sure.
And those pages tend to be, or the submissions tend to be, you know, more than 5,000 pages long. And so for people to be able to replicate content in specific places, you know, fill in the blank a certain way, AI can help with that. It can help summarize what any particular page says, any particular
yeah.
section says. So it can basically take the boring part and the repetitive part out of people's jobs and then let them go do the higher level work that really uses their brain power.
Absolutely. Do you have two or three good, like your best pieces of advice for companies to remain competitive? And maybe two good pieces of advice and one bad piece of advice.
Okay, and in hiring people or in general?
Yeah. No, just in general for companies to kind of access and utilize AI best.
Yeah, so I think that the big thing to do right now is to maybe start an experiment with AI and
yeah.
start an experiment with machine learning, because despite all the hype, you know, if you read enough of the press, you'd think everybody's doing it. They have, you know, 600 data scientists and things like that. And while that might be true at Facebook or a place like that, they might have 1,000 data scientists.
Right.
But if you look at a bank like JP Morgan Chase, you know, they're actually still going to have about 50 of them, you know, and they'll have all these different departments that want to use them. And what else would be really good is if there were a group of data scientists or a group of AI people who all knew each other, because
sure.
in companies, what happens is that one department hires some people, one department hires some people, another department hires some people, and those people don't know each other.
Common company silo effect.
Yeah.
But, yeah, if they've worked together before in teams, collaboration obviously helps. What, you know, I said bad piece of advice just to be fun, but what is something that you see being done in practice in AI company level that maybe could be improved the most?
Well, and one of them is more collaboration.
Sure. Kind of all comes back to that, right?
That, yeah, I think, and the other thing is best practices, you know, so that people aren't relearning the same stuff over and over again.
Yeah.
So I think that would help a lot. probably leaders who understood what AI is and, you know, what it can and can't do. Because you see a commercial on TV or, you know, you listen to something on Bloomberg, you know, and these executives come into the office and say, hey, let's do that. You know, and this thing is, you know, not yet possible.
Where does that degree in machine learning AI kind of rank with tech recruiters these days?
I'm sorry, I caught.
Oh, I was just saying, where does an AI machine learning degree rank with tech recruiters right now?
Well, so one is that people are difficult to recruit. They're not hard to find.
Sure.
So we can identify
them.
Well,
because they have options, right? You know, it's kind of almost supply and demand, right?
Well, that partly, and the other thing is that companies still grade these jobs, you know, not according to, you know, this is the hottest commodity and I'm going to have to pay $30,000 more. You know, they're not willing to do that. They're
so
willing.
So the wage isn't catching up with the demand yet, basically.
Right. So they understand that they have to do that, but they're, you know, but they're basically have a level 8 position or a level 10 position and they can't go above the midpoint of that position to bring in a new person.
And see, that might be the most important point mentioned today, because we talk about these in silos, right? We all people in this room or in this box get excited about this, but at the corporate level, if we haven't caught up on that, right, that's what's making things difficult. And it's just, you know, it's hard to move a giant ship versus a speedboat, right?
Well, and I think that the name your price thing is just, especially, you know, that's the place where the economy still is where it is.
Sure.
You know, it's somewhat stuck there.
Yeah.
Where and so they're not ready to let people name their price yet. And, you know, and people are basically, companies are doing everything they can to keep you comfortable.
Yeah.
You know, if you're an AI person working there, you know.
Sure. They'll throw benefits, they'll throw.
Well, and the other thing is yeah, and a lot of these people like to do research.
Yes.
And so it means that they get to take a month off to go publish a paper or
that's
to go
research. That's a different functionality inside of a company that may not be used to that, right?
The companies aren't used to that yet, and the people are. You know, they spend all this time at Stanford getting their PhD.
Right, so they might wonder why after a couple months that person's already gone, even though they're paying.
Well, no. I mean, literally what these companies and some advertising agencies do is they say, you know, go write a paper, and, you know, and obviously what the company does is loses productivity of a person for that amount of time.
And they can maybe win back that with, you know, cachet or being able to be thought leaders in the business, but it's hard in the here and now.
Well, no, and what I'm missing, I guess, the point I'm missing getting through is that those people don't actually leave those jobs to write papers. What they do
that's their focus rather than, you know,
they get some paid time off to go do that.
Yeah.
And companies have to provide that, and if they don't, then, you know, those people won't do that, because what they want to know is, you know, I'm interested in advancing your career from an academic perspective and from doing experiments that may not ever materialize to anything that's any good for my company.
That's another good point. Well, Virginia, thanks so much for joining me in the tank.
Great, nice to meet you.
Yeah, very nice.
Nice talking with you.
Thank you. And again, follow us at hashtag AdobeTT, and that's today's Adobe Think Tank.